Pile foundation introduction. What is a pile? Pile is a long member, slender member, structural member, vertical member, and it is made up of steel or column or wood. Any material can be used. As you know, in olden days they used wood, then came the steel, and nowadays we put concrete inside the concrete for making the pile. The pile is either driven into the soil or it can be cast in situ. It can be a precast pile or it can be a cast in situ pile. We excavate a hole in the ground and we will put concrete in it. We will fill the concrete in it. And pier. Pier is another type of deep foundation. And what is pier? Is the same as the vertical column, but cross section is larger than the pile. Pier's cross section is larger than the pile. Usually the diameter wise it is larger than the pile. Pier, mostly piers vandu we will use under bridges. We use the pier foundation. Then we have caissons. Caissons are well foundations. They are very huge diameter, and underwater structures like offshore platforms, we go for this caisson foundations. Okay, first pile foundation. We will focus on pile foundation and why it is used. As you all know, if the load is heavy, the load from the superstructure is heavy, we go for pile foundation. If the soil has poor bearing capacity, we go for pile foundation. And if in case the pumping of water from the ground is, we call that as dewatering. If the water is more, we remove the excess water and reduce the water level, and then we will lay the foundation. Instead, if the pumping of water is very difficult and water is continuously seeping into the soil, we couldn't control the water in the soil, then we can go for pile foundation. And when there is large fluctuations in the groundwater level, we can go for pile foundation. For example, in slopy areas or some soils near river banks, பக்கத்தில் இருக்கக்கூடிய பில்டிங்ஸில் வந்து தேர் வில் பி ஃப்ளக்சுவேஷன்ஸ் ஆஃப் வாட்டர் லெவல். இன் ரெய்னி சீசன்ஸ் த கிரவுண்ட் வாட்டர் லெவல் வில் ஆல்சோ இன்க்ரீஸ். ஸோ அந்த தேட் கேசஸ் யூ ஹாவ் டு வரி அபவுட் பைல் வாட்டர் இன் த சாயில். ஸோ யூ ஹாவ் டு வரி கோ ஃபார் பைல் ஃபவுண்டேஷன். அண்ட் whenever the structures are near river or seashore, there is a problem of horizontal transmission of water into the land from water beds. From river beds or from sea will seep into the, horizontally seep into the land sides. Site-க்குள்ள வந்துருச்சு அப்படின்னா, then we have to worry about covering actions. Erosion of soil by water particle is covering. So covering actions also we should be worried of. So we can go for pile foundation. Then foundations near drainages, deep drainages or canals, and foundation of offshore platform, heavy structures like transmission towers and offshore platforms, we have to go for pile foundation, because transmission towers and all, they are subjected to wind actions. Wind action and asymmetrical loads, trusses, wind actions are adhigama irukum. And the loads are transferred both horizontally and vertically as well as inclined ways. So in this cases, transmission towers, platforms, we need to go for pile foundation. It's covering action. You can see the water covering the soil. In these structures, we have to go for pile foundation. Offshore platforms. Inside the sea, we have platforms for oil rigging, oil taking and all. In those cases also, we have to go for pile foundations. Okay, large towers, we go for pile foundations. Okay, how will you select a pile foundation? there are different types of pile foundations. And how will you select a pile foundations? First of all, we should know what is the arch structure is, whether it is offshore platform or whether it is a transmission tower or whether it is a what is the type of the structure. We should be sure of it, and we should know what is the location, whether it is near the river bank or whether it is near the river seashore. We should know the location. Then we should know about the materials, whether the pile is going to be a concrete pile or it is going to be a steel pile or it is going to be a timber pile. We should know the material of the pile. We should know the equipments used for driving the piles. Also, we should know the fund, how much fund we have. Then we should know the type of soil and its properties like bearing capacity, shear strength. We should know the properties of the soil. We should also know about the groundwater table, and we should know the durability of the pile. If you use a wooden pile, the durability is very less. When you use a steel pile near a water area, then it is subjected to corrosion. So we go for concrete pile. So we should choose the durability of the pile. And we should finalize the length of the pile, number of pile, and also we should know nearby buildings, how the nearby buildings are constructed. Also, we should know how we can drive the pile, because piles are driven into the ground. Imagine a column, which is precast column, which is driven into a ground. When you are driving, there will be a lot of vibrations, a lot of forces given. We are pushing the huge pile into the ground against gravity. So it is kind of heavy work, heavy process involved in it. So we should know about the adjacent building, and we should also know about the facility for pile driving. Also, we should know the erosion of the soil in the structure. So here comes the classification of the piles. A very important question. Based on function, it is classified. Based on materials, it is classified. Based on methods of installation, it is classified. First, based on functions. First is end bearing pile. As I said, when the soil is low bearing capacity, instead of transferring the load from the superstructure to the soil, we will directly transfer the load from superstructure to the rocky stratum. Rocky stratum, which is present very deep below the soil. So that is the idea for pile foundation. Instead of soil taking the load, we will transfer the load entirely to the rock below the soil. In such a way, we are escalating the soil in between. So we are transferring the load to the end of the ground, that is rock. So this is called end bearing pile. Second pile is friction pile. Sometimes the rock may be very deep. We cannot dig very deep into the rocks. And the madri cases le, we should go for the second option. We should see whether the soil is sandy soil. If the soil is sandy soil, then instead of inserting the pile foundation into the rock, we will just leave it at some length. Okay. Why? Because sandy soils have the frictional property. So because of the friction between the pile and the soil, the load is transferred through the frictional resistance from the soil. So this is called frictional pile. Especially sandy soils alone, we go for friction pile. Next, we have compaction pile. Compaction pile is when the soil is very loose, we insert the pile foundation. The idea is when the soil is very loose, if you நீங்க கடற்கரையில் இன் சீ ஷோஸ் யூ மைட் ஹவ் பிளேட் பில்டிங் ஹவுசஸ் யூசிங் த சீ சாண்ட் எவ்ரி ஒன் உட் ஹவ் டன் தட் we know that when it goes beyond some height, it will fall down, it will collapse down. To avoid the collapsing of the sea sand, try put putting a rod inside and then putting a heaping the sea sand, then it will stand. Why it can stand? Because of the support provided by the rod which we have given inside the sea sand. So similarly, when you drive the pile inside the loose sand, the loose sand will become densified because of the pile we have inserted. Okay, so that compaction pile, we have another pile called tension pile, and we have anchor pile. In sea, we have anchor pile, fender pile, batter pile, and sheet pile. We see one by one. End bearing pile, the load is penetrating to the soft soil, and the tip of the pile will be, end of the pile will be inside the rocky stratum. So the load is directly transferred to the rock. It will act like a column. And here the load which is taken by the pile, QU, ultimate load, taken by the pile, QU, ultimate load, is equal to QP. What is QP? Means the point bearing resistance. Remember this term, problems la use pannuvom. The ultimate load is equal to QP. QP is called point bearing or tip bearing or base bearing. You know, the last end is bearing the entire load. So it is called point bearing or tip bearing or base bearing. So QP is end bearing or pile load resistance. Next, we have friction pile. When the soil is a sand, then the sand will give some frictional resistance to the pile. With this resistance, the load is transferred into the soil. So, in sandy soils, we have this frictional pile. Here, the ultimate load is equal to frictional resistance. Skin friction, frictional resistance QS. Frictional resistance QS or skin friction, because skin is involved in the load transfer. In the before case, it is end bearing. The end is bearing. The tip is involved in the transferring of the load. So, there QU is equal to QP. The point, the end point is bearing. So, there QU is equal to QP. Here, the skin friction on the surface of the soil, on the pile, the skin friction will be there. The surface will be resisting. So, QU is equal to QS here. Skin friction. Okay. It depends on the length, the diameter. It is depending upon the roughness of the pile surface also. Next is compaction pile. Compaction is when you insert the pile foundations into the soil, they will increase the bearing capacity of the soil. Idhanala da we have some concepts like stone column and all. Stone column abdina, if you find the soil is very loose, then they will put some holes into the bore holes madri. They will put some holes in the ground and fill it with aggregates. Aggregates which they will fill it. That is called stone column. Because of this, enna idea na loose sand vandu angange edavadhu reinforcements kudutha that soil will become dense. So so their bearing capacity will also increase. So that is the idea for compaction pile. They do not involve in load transfer mechanism, but just they will improve the bearing capacity of the soil. Next is tension pile. When the pile, these piles are of length very small. Construction buildings la varadhu madri, unlike the piles in the buildings where the piles are very long, here in the piles in the pile foundation below the transmission towers are going to be short, and these are called tension piles. Okay, tension piles. Especially why in especially where water pressure is very high and wind pressure is very high, we go for this tension pile. When wind pressure is very high and water pressure is very high, there will be uplift forces. Uplift forces means the forces will be kappa. We know that forces always, load will act from டாப் டு பாட்டம் மேலேருந்து தான் கீழே வரும் ஆல்வேஸ் த லோடு. பட் சம்டைம்ஸ் டியூ டு த ப்ரெஷர் இன் த கிரவுண்ட் லேட்ரல் ஃபோர்ஸஸ் இன் த கிரவுண்ட் தேர் வில் பி அப்லிஃப்டிங் லோட்ஸ் அப்ளைங் இந்த ஆப்போசிட் டைரக்ஷன் ஃப்ரம் த கிரவுண்ட். தோஸ் ஆர் அப்லிஃப்டிங் ஃபோர்ஸஸ். தே ஆர் எனிமீஸ் டு த ஸ்ட்ரக்சர்ஸ். ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி கேசஸில் டு அவாய்ட் த அப்லிஃப்டிங் ஆஃப் த சாயில் சாரி அப்லிஃப்டிங் ஆஃப் த ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் வி ஹாவ் டு கோ ஃபார் foundations like pile foundations, and especially when the water pressure is very high, you know, we go for tension piles. Next we have anchor piles. Anchor piles means for example big ships, even small boats and they will tie with some firm structure. So then when the boats are resting in the harbor, they will tie the ship boats or small ships with the strong structure. Similarly, when you have a harbor la vandu big ships ella anchor panni vekkiradhukku, we need some structures. Or harbors le we have some structures, they are all built with anchor piles. They resist the horizontal loads they resist. And fender piles are nothing but similar to anchor piles, but they are used mostly in harbors alone. ஹார்பர்ஸ் இந்த மாதிரி ஸ்ட்ரக்சர்ஸ் பார்த்துருப்பீங்க. ஆர் வென் வாட்டர் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர்ஸ் லைக் பிக் லேக்ஸ் ஆர் த பிரிட்ஜஸ் அக்ராஸ் த லேக்ஸ் ஆர் த ஷிப்ஸ் அக்ராஸ் சாரி ஹார்பர்ஸ் தோஸ் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர்ஸ் வி ஹாவ் திஸ் ஃபெண்டர் பைல்ஸ். வை வி ஹாவ் நீட் ஃபெண்டர் பைல்ஸ் இஸ் வென் ஷிப்ஸ் மூவ் தே வில் எக்ஸர்ட் லாட் ஆஃப் ப்ரெஷர் இன் த when the ships are moving laterally, the water will move, the water will impact the nearby structures, then we have to go for this kind of fender pile. Next pile is so these are the diagrammatic representations of the pile. Next pile is batter pile. Batter pile means we provide inclined piles. We instead of providing vertical piles, we provide inclined piles. This is also used in offshore platforms and waterfront structures, because horizontally the water pressure is very high. Then we go for batter piles. Next pile is sheet pile. We have sheets, corrugated sheets as shown in the picture, and you can see the installation of the piles. Sheet piles, sheet-sheetah irukkum, mari corrugated sheets will be there and they are installed into the soil. Why we have to go for sheet pile is, if you are building a G plus 12 structure, imagine you are going to have to build a G plus 12 structure, and this G plus 12 structure is going to be a residential flat house with 2 BHK, 3 BHK, it's a big flat, okay, it's a 3 BHK flat, and we have to build it in a site which is very complicated. I'll explain the situations of the site. When you take the site has 4 sides, okay, 4 sides. On one side we have a temple, and the temple lake is, we have the pond in the lakes, no, and the ponds in the temple. So we have a huge pond on back side of the site, okay. On the left side we have G plus 15 commercial building on the left side, and on the right side of the site we have we have a big company, that is also a commercial room, like a shopping mall. A huge shopping mall is there on the right side. Now you have to build a structure in between this, okay. So as we know, our structure is going to be G plus 12 building. For a G plus 12 building, imagine we should go for all
we should go for, since it's a tall structure, we should go for pile foundations. So when you are going for pile foundations, now the excavations is going to be huge. One of the problem is the soil site is loose. Another problem, soil site is going to be loose. Second problem, the pond is very nearby, so the water can seep inside our site. When you excavate more, the water will automatically seep into our site. Water from the pond will seep into our site. So that is the second problem. Third problem, when you have to excavate more, vibrations are going to be there. Munadi, I have said, when you excavate the ground, there will be caving in of soil. Why? Because the soil will lose. We are reducing the pressure here by excavating. So the soil will move laterally from the stronger side, denser side, to this excavated part. So the nearby structure is under threat. So in the manner of complicated structure is going to be there, Abdina, we can follow some methods like, as I said, to avoid the caving in of soil. Now in this project, if the caving in of soil happens, then the huge building that is standing nearby will collapse. So we should be very careful to strengthen the soil present below the foundation of the nearby building. What can we do? We can just put a sheet pile between our site and that site. So when you excavate the soil, the sheet pile will resist the soil moving laterally from the nearby building site to our site. So the caving in of soil can be avoided by providing this kind of sheet piles. Okay. So sheet piles will cut off the uplift forces and hydraulic forces also. Sheet piles can be concrete made or steel made, or it can be timber made. Okay. Second classification is made up based on pile material. Material na, three popular materials: concrete, steel, timber, and there are composite materials also. We'll look into one by one. Concrete piles la, we have precast concrete piles, cast in situ concrete piles, and pre-stressed concrete piles. First, precast concrete piles. What is precast? We cast the pile in this companies outside the site, and we will bring it and we will just install it. All the metro projects, all the over bridges are made up of this precast concretes only, precast concrete piles. Usually the piles will vary from 50 centimeter to 30 centimeter in cross section, and the length will be more than 20 meter. And the grade of the concrete is M20. Above M20, it will be there. We'll bring the pile into the site and we will install with the machine. You can see this is a precast concrete pile. It's a precast pile. By using the drilling machine, we will just push the precast concrete pile into the ground. So this is precast concrete piles. Next, we have cast in situ concrete pile. We'll drill a borehole. Then we will send a reinforcement cage. Reinforcement cage means the reinforcements are tied outside the ground, and then they are inserted into, like columns, we should tie the reinforcements, and then we will insert into the borehole, and then we will pour the concrete. So that is cast inside pile, cast in situ pile. Sometimes we provide a casing. Can see in this picture, we are providing a casing. A casing is there. To avoid the caving in of boreholes, we provide a casing, and then we will insert the reinforcement cage, and then we will pour the concrete inside. Okay. So this is a reinforcement. Okay. This is cased cast in situ piles. There are uncased cast in situ piles also. Instead of putting this mold here, instead of providing a casing here, we will not provide any casing. We'll just dig the borehole, insert the reinforcement cage, and then pour the concrete. There are types of cast in situ pile, Raymond's pile, MacArthur pile, BSB base driven pile, swag pile, and button bottom piles. There are different types of piles. And uncased piles, we have simplex pile, Frankie pile, vibro pile, pedestal pile, and pressure pile. These are some other types of piles. Okay, steel piles. Steel piles are mostly used in harbors. Harbors, offshore platforms, we have steel piles, but they are of H piles, box piles, and tube piles. You'll see what is what. H piles, you can see the cross section of this piles as H, the shape of H. One direction, it will look like I, but it's actually H piles. This H piles are used for they will act like a column, and they have small cross section area. Since it's in the shape of H, the cross section area is very small, so we can drive it very easily into the ground. The piles are longer. You can make it as long piles, and they have high bearing capacity also. Box piles, you can see the cross section. It will look like a box, and it is not easily when H piles cannot be easily penetrated into the ground, you can go for box piles. It can be orthogonal pile or rectangular in shape. Then we have tube piles, like plastic tubes. We have bigger piles. In the middle, it will be hollow. In the middle portion, they will pour some concrete. Okay, tube piles. And tube piles are driven easily into the ground. Concrete is filled inside the steel tubes, and mostly circular in cross section, and it is easy to handle and easy to drive inside the ground. Next is timber piles or composite piles. You can see these piles, no? Half we have timber, above the water we have timber, below the water we have steel. So two different materials are composite piles. Simply we cannot use timber piles in the ground. If we use the timber piles in the ground, no, there will be termite attack. Because of the termite attack, because of the moisture content in the soil, there will be lot of termite attack in the timber, and the complete destruction of the timber. So timber piles are not mostly used these days. But however, sometimes they provide outer coating around the timber, like a sleeve arrangement, like outer coating around the sleeve, and then insert into the ground. Next is composite piles, half timber, half concrete, or half steel and half timber. Those are two different materials connected together to form a single pile, and then they are driven into the site or soil. The durability, you can see when you use concrete and timber pile, the durability of concrete pile is very high, and the cost of timber pile is less. So we can use the advantages of that both piles in one pile itself. Okay, next is sand pile. Just they will make some boreholes in the soil, and we will pour some sand into it. That will become a pile, sand pile. And these piles, and the sand, it is poured inside, no, it is thoroughly compacted. And we should see that when you are placing the sand should be little wet. Okay, third classification is based on methods of installation. Methods of installation, it is classified as driven pile, driven cast in situ pile, bored cast in situ piles, screw piles, and jacked piles. First, you'll see driven pile. Driven pile, na, precast piles are driven piles. We just drive the pile into the ground using machines. You can see the placing the pile above the ground in the first step. Second, it is inserted halfway through, then completely inserted. You can see the completely inserted pile into the ground in the third picture. So we'll drive using hammer. You can see, no, this is a hammer pressure. And the above hanging, the crane la hang aayittirukadhu vandu hammer. The hammer is taken up and down, up and down. Percussion action or veetla vandu oral paathirpinga for smashing the pulverizing the rice into flour. In olden days they used the tools, rammer like tools. Mari mala thooki thooki podumbodhu the pile will be driven into the ground. Okay, so these are driven piles. Driven and cast in situ piles, it's like we will drive the casing alone inside and then we will pour the concrete inside. That is driven and cast in situ piles. Then bored and cast in situ piles. Bored and cast in, we will first put a borehole and then we will pour the concrete in the site. That is bored and cast in situ piles. Screw piles, they are like screw piles will have some thread like pattern, as in the nails of the steel nails that we are driving in the walls, you know. The similarly the nails madri we have twisted threads in the piles. These are screw piles. Next we have jacked piles. Jacked piles means nowadays this jacked piles are used like, you know, that நம்ம பழைய நம்ம தாத்தா பாட்டி வீடு ஆர் ஈவன் சம் ஆஃப் த ரெசிடென்ஷியல் ஹவுசஸ் இன் வில்லேஜ் ஏரியாஸ், இஃப் வி சீ தீஸ் ஹவுசஸ் வில் ஹாவ் அ லைஃப் டைம் ஆஃப் மேக்ஸிமம் 50 to 75 years ஒன்லி. Okay, after that it will become old, it will call for some demolishment and rehabilitation works. So foundation also it will have a lifetime of only 50 years to 100 years, that's all. Okay, so when you take the foundation, how to renovate a foundation in a old structure? Mostly if it is a load-bearing structure, we can renovate the foundation by excavating the soil near the, it's a technique, carefully done technique. If we have to renovate an old building, then we can use this technique of jacked pile. It's side la irukka soil fulla we will excavate and then we will use a jacked pile below the existing foundation. If the older structure is a load-bearing structure, then we can use this type of technique by reinforcing the foundation below the already existing foundation by providing jack structure, jack, hydraulic jack. Eppadi nama vandu changing the tires of the vehicle, so four-wheelers we change the by provide jack vachi we will rise it up and then provide a new wheel in the four wheelers. Similarly is the jacked pile. Next pile is underreamed pile, especially when the soil is black cotton soil or it is a clay, so highly expansive clay soil, it is subjected to swelling and shrinkage. It will swell when water is there and it will shrink when water is not there. So expansive clays la black cotton soil la expansive clay soils la we need a special type of foundation which can adapt to the alternate swelling and shrinkage of the soil. So that kind of pile is called underreamed pile. Instead of normal vertical pile, we provide a pile foundation which has some bulb on the sides. You can see the diagram. See, instead of providing a vertical pile, we provide some bulging, bulged pile.
in some portions alone. That bulged portion is called, this bulged portion is called a bulb, B-U-L-B, bulb. So this is a single bulb pile, and we have three bulbs here. So if the length of the clay is more, expansive soil is more, then we provide this bulbed pile. This was first developed by CBRI, Central Building Research Institute in Roorkee, and this is for foundations serving black cotton soil with, because they have very poor bearing capacity also. So underreamed pile will have one or more bulb with it. Bulb means in that portion alone the concrete will be bulging. And so it is also called underreamed. And they are formed by underreamed tool. And the diameter of the pile is, the pile diameter is 20 to 50 centimeter, and the bulb diameter is 2 to 3 times that of the diameter of the pile. The diameter of the pile is 20 centimeter, then we will provide a 40 centimeter bulb. Okay, so 2 to 3 times the diameter of the pile, and the length of the pile is from 3 to 8 meter, and the spacing between the piles should be 2 to 4 meter. Okay, by providing this bulb at the base, we increase the bearing capacity or load carrying capacity. And the vertical spacing between the bulbs in this picture, no, multi-bulb piles, you see 3 bulbs are there. And the spacing between the piles should be 1.25 to 1.5 times the diameter of the bulb. And for this will reduce the uplift poses. Also, it will provide better anchorage to the black cotton soil. Black cotton soils are nothing but expansive clays. And the equipment required for the construction of the piles are spiral auger, which is for boring. Then we need a auger boring. Then second, we need under reamer. Using that, we can make the bulbs inside the ground. Then we need a boring guide. Boring guide is nothing but a casing. Outline for casing is needed so that caving in of soil will not happen while drilling into the ground. So first step, we will insert the auger into the ground and we will make a borehole. Then we will use an under reamer to excavate the soil in the sides. There it will provide the bulb in the it is like a reinforcement tool. It will insert it and we can drill the sides in the bulb varakudiya portions la mattum it will excavate the soil. So this is bulb. When you are inserting, no, the under reamer la irukkakudiya tool la irukkakudiya in the portion will be automatic. Abdi closed a irukum. When after inserting into the borehole, we'll release it, then it will make this kind of bulb impression into the borehole. Then we will pour the place our reinforcement cage. Reinforcement is placed. RCC na we will put for pile foundation. So we'll place the reinforcement cage, then we will pour the concrete. We'll fill the concrete inside. Okay, so these are the 4 stages in making the pile. Sorry, underreamed pile. So underreamed pile mattu thaniya 8 marks ku ketirukanga. So pile accessories. The till now we saw the classification of the piles. So and a pile, when you are inserting the pile, we should know some other criteria also. This is not for your examination. This from this pile accessories is not for your examination. Just for your knowledge, I am telling you. We need to know about 3 things. One is pile cap. பயில் வந்து சிங்கிள் பயிலாக எப்போவுமே நம்ம உள்ள கிரவுண்டில் எக்ஸ்கவேட் இன்சர்ட் பண்ண மாட்டோம். ஆல்வேஸ் தேர் வில் பி நிறைய பைல்ஸ் இன்சர்டட் அண்ட் ஆல் த பைல்ஸ் வில் பி கனெக்டட் டு அ காமன் பேஸ் திஸ் இஸ் அ பைல் ஃபவுண்டேஷன் ஃபார் அ டிரான்ஸ்மிஷன் டவர் வென் யூ சீனோ ஒன் ஒரு டிரான்ஸ்மிஷன் டவரோட ஒரு இடத்துல வர்றதுலேயே 3 பைல்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் ஆல் தி த்ரீ பைல்ஸ் ஆர் கனெக்டட் டு அ ஒரு பிளேட் மாதிரி மேலே இருக்குது. தி த்ரீ பைல்ஸ் ஆர் கனெக்டட் டு ஒன் பிளேட் அண்ட் திஸ் பிளேட் இஸ் கால்ட் பைல் கேப். ஆஃப்ட் அபவ் த பைல் கேப் ஓன்லி வி வில் கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ட் அவர் காலம்ஸ் அண்ட் எவ்ரி திங். சிமிலர்லி இஸ் அவர் ப்ராஜெக்ட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ, பில்டிங் ப்ராஜெக்ட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ. After putting all the piles, we will connect the piles with a single slab and that is called pile cap. So the load is transferred to the pile cap. The pile cap will transfer to the pile foundation. Okay, so that is pile cap. Then we have pile shoes. Pile shoes means where always we will drive the piles into the ground. When we are driving the precast piles into the ground, the bottom of the pile may get damaged. And to avoid the damage caused to the bottom of the pile, we provide pile shoes. This kind of pile shoes will be placed in below the pile. The pile shoes can be of conical shape like this, or it can be a square pile shoe. And the cross section will be, bottom of the cone will be like a square. Then we have a wedge shaped pile shoe. Then we have a steel strap pile shoe. Then we have a socket type pile shoe. We have closed end pile shoes. In the olden days, they used timber for driving. Nowadays, we have steel or iron shoes are used for driving the piles into the ground so that the bottom of the piles will not be damaged. So for driving the pile, we need some rammer or a hammer, and that is called pile driver or pile hammer. And the pile hammer la vandu there are different types. Piling rig. Machines like this are used to drive into the grounds. In our OMR road itself, when they were excavating soil for metro projects, we saw this equipments. The equipments la paathirpinga, like the crane attached with a long lead, and the piles will be inserted using this structures into the ground. These are called pile rig. And the big see, this gives a better picture. The piles are holded by the catched by the, or the pile holder is called leads. Then we have winches to, like, it will serve like a motor. When you switch it on, it will go up and down like a motor. That's a winch. Winches are used for driving the pile. Then we have pile hammer. The pile hammer, we have three types. Many types. They are drop hammer. Then we have single acting hammer, double acting hammer. We have diesel hammer and vibratory hammer. First is drop hammer. Drop hammer, na, we lift a hammer and drop it down. The free fall of the hammer will happen. Like, we will drop it, we will pick it up to some height, then we will just drop it from top. Okay, that is drop hammer. This is the oldest method for driving the pile into the ground. Okay, and the hammer falls under gravity. That is drop hammer. Single acting hammer, we use steam pressure to raise the hammer and drop the hammer. Dropping is gravity. For lifting up the hammer, we use steam pressure. That is single acting hammer. The weight of the hammer is only up to 10,000 kg in single acting. Double acting also, we have a hammer. We rise using air pressure or steam pressure, but here we have higher weight, more than 10,000 kg. Vibratory hammer, by inducing vibrations in the pile, we insert the pile into the ground. Then we have pile extractor. What is pile extractor means? Sometimes the piles are abandoned. தப்பாக போட்டிருப்பாங்க, இல்லை பைல்ஸோட சைட் லொக்கேஷன் தப்பாக போட்டிருப்பாங்க. த என்ஜினியர் வில் டெல் ஒன் பிளேஸ் பட் த கான்ட்ராக்டர் வில் புட் த த இல்லை அந்த ஜேசிபி மேன் வில் புட் த போர்ஹோல் இன் அனதர் பிளேஸ் அண்ட் அதில் கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷனே போட்டு முடிச்சிருப்பாங்க அண்டர் அண்டர் வெரி இம்ப்ராப்பர் சூப்பர்விஷன் அண்ட் ஆல் மெனி ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் இன் சைட் மே ஹேப்பன். ஸோ தீஸ் ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் கேன் பி இந்த மாதிரி கேசஸில் ஆஃப்டர் இன்சர்ட்டிங் த பைல் சம்டைம்ஸ் வி மே ஹாவ் டு எக்ஸ்ட்ராக்ட் த பைல் அவுட் சைட் that for that once pile is driven full pile pota pro extract panna mudiyadu but sometimes when casing ella insert pannadukapra we can remove the casing so we need some extractors so we need some extractors they use technique like how we open our coca cola the bottles coca cola bottles with the we use some special tools to open the Pepsi bottles and all. No, not the plastic bottles, the glass bottles and all. Similarly, we have extractors to take out the casings of the piles. This is vibration pullings. Okay, pile can also fail. See, a building entirely collapsed because அப்படியே அந்த பைல்ஸ் வந்து லைக் ட்ரீஸ் வந்து ரூட்ஸோட வெளியில் வர மாதிரி கம்மிங் அவுட் ஆஃப் த லைக் கொலாப்ஸ் ஆகிற மாதிரி சி த பைல்ஸ் கேன் ஆல்சோ ஃபெயில் வென் த லேட்ரல் ப்ரெஷர் இஸ் மோர் அண்ட் த அப்லிஃப்ட் ப்ரெஷர் இஸ் மோர் திஸ் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ஃபெயிலியர்ஸ் கேன் ஹேப்பன் சி தி என்டையர்லி த பைல்ஸ் வேர் ஆல்சோ அப்ரூட்டட் பை த கிரவுண்ட் அப்ரூட்டட் ஃப்ரம் த சாயில் கம்ப்ளீட் கொலாப்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர்ஸ் கேன் ஆல்சோ happen uprooting of the piles so these are some of the reasons of the pile so from next class we will move into the problems and load